What's going on, everybody? My name is Kyle Welcher. I fish the Bassmaster Elite Series, and I appreciate you clicking on this video. So, with me fishing the Bassmaster Elite Series, I fish all over the country, from Florida all the way up to New York. This is my first year on the Elite Series. The last year, I traveled over the country as well and fished the Opens and two divisions of the FOW Toyota Series now. But anyways, I want to bring you these videos, the True Series. If y'all been watching my channel, you already know what this is. And today we're talking about swim baits. So if you want to know swim baits, this is the video where I tell you all about, I know about swim baits. But the True Series was supposed to be is, I open up my boat, I take out exactly what I keep in my boat, literally exactly what I keep in my boat 365 days a year, and I show you what I keep in my boat legitimately. Now, a lot of these fishermen, they do recap videos, and everything that they plug is bait they're sponsored by, and that's all good. But I'm gonna show you what I keep in my boat, and I had to pay for each and every one of these pretty much. So, start off, swim baits like this right here. That's, I keep a ton of these in my boat. I've always kept these in my boat. Basically, this is just like a 3.5 inch. This is actually the net bait little spanky. And here's a Reaction Innovations 5-inch skinny dipper. I keep a lot of these in my boat, and I throw these primarily as trailers on the back of swim jigs, chatterbaits. I throw this small one on the back of spinnerbait. Like, I dictate these trailers based on, I'll throw this small little trailer in really clear water, or if I want the bait to get a little bit deeper and reel it at a pretty fast speed. If I need a little bit more lift on the bait, or if I'm in a little bit more stained water fishing super shallow, I could put this bait right here on like a 3/8 ounce chatterbait and reel it super slow, and it's going to only get down like 1.5 feet deep. So I change my trailers up based on exactly how deep I want to fish, water clarity, or the bait that I'm doing. And I keep these style swim baits, a few bags of each, in my boat at all times. Like, half of this box right here is actually filled with swim baits. So from here to the end of it is all swim baits, and mostly trailer style swim baits that I, you know, I never throw these on like an open hook or an open water or anything like that. Now, the ones that I throw in open water or a line through style, I package them in these upriver bags right here. That's how I keep them in my boat right here. So you can see, this is the problem with swim baits, is one bag, two bags, three bags, four bags of swim bait stay in my boat at all times. And I do take a lot of these out before the tournament day. If I'm not really catching them on it, I'll only, you know, leave a few variations in my boat, and I'll put all these other ones in the truck. But for the most part, when I pull up to a lake to practice, I have all these in my boat. And the reason for that is the Kytex style bait. So Strike King now has a really good one called the Rage Swimmer, but they're all made on a mold just like a Strike, just like a Kytex. So basically, I keep these style baits in a few different colors, and you can see right here, I actually keep these small little ones for just tiny little bitty trailers on the back of stuff, and then I keep some green pumpkins right here. So these are all my super small swim baits, and the Kytex is a very, very powerful bait for fishing in open water. It has a very unique action that, say, the skinny dipper or that little spanky just does not have, and it cannot emulate a Kytex. Like, a Kytex is hard to duplicate as far as with other styles. A lot of brands are coming out with one that looks exactly like the Kytex, and they're able to do that, but for the most part, it's very difficult. Like, you just need to have a bait of that style in your boat at all times. And you can see right here, I keep in this bag right here, I've got green pumpkin ones, I've got black ones, I've got white ones, and I keep mostly the smaller ones. Like, this is a 3.8 inch, that's gonna be the biggest one that's in this bag, and I throw this usually on a 3/16 to a quarter, even a 3/4 ounce, a 3/8 ounce, not a 3/4, 3/8 ounce swim bait head, the Untamed Tackle Scout swim bait head, is what I'm normally gonna throw these on in 3.8 inch. Then the 3.3, I'll go down to a little bit smaller one. And, you know, that's just what I keep in here, is a couple different color variations of every single size, and I have to keep enough of them. So if I really get on a bite throwing a 2.8, I'm gonna have to have like three, you know, clamshell packages of these. So I've got three of each color pretty much, and then if I get on a bite with a 3.8, I need three of these. And it takes up a lot of space, and they're very difficult to store. But that's what I keep as far as small Kytex in my boat, is I keep a lot of that. And then I've got some medium size Jackal Rhythm Waves. Haven't thrown these a lot, but they do have a very different action than this. Still have a very good thump and track, really, really good in the water. I've been really impressed with these, but I don't really see the application as much as I do for like a Kytex. So you can see, I keep a ton of these small little Kytex in here. Organization is very, very difficult, but I can stick them in these upriver bags and kind of keep them out of the way at least a little. And you can see I've got a couple of little crappie swim baits in there. And I can put these on the back of all kind of these smaller baits, a little trailer that just needs a little bit less thump or something like that. I'll put it on the back of a super small buzz bait or a little spinner bait or something like that. I put these little trailers on a few things. I never throw those on an open hook, but because they're in the clamshell, I put them right back in here. So I keep that many 3.3, to 3.8 Kytex in my boat, and I really shouldn't, but I do, and I just got so much confidence in it when the fishing gets tough. So that's one bag down. Let's go to the next one. Same exact thing right here. These are just duplicate 3.8 inch Kytex. You know, I shouldn't have, these really should not be in the boat because they're just extras. These should actually probably go in the truck or something, but that's just 3.75 Strike Kings and 3.8 Kytex, but they do go in the boat. Those are all shad colors just in case they start smashing them. And then the same deal right here, I keep a few boxes of the 5.8 and the 4.8. So you can see there's a Strike King and a Kytex side by side. This right here is the 4.75, this is the 5.8. Really, really good sizes for catching a lot of fish and still catching, you know, some 5 and 6 pounders, but I've caught 1.5 pounders on this bait as well. They just choke it from all sizes, and it's a really good way to get bites whenever it's a little bit tougher, but you still are trying to imitate like a gizzard shad instead of a thread fin. I'll go with like a 5.8 or even a 4.75. Looks more like a gizzard than a thread fin in my opinion. So I only keep those in two colors. I don't keep these in green pumpkin anymore. I only keep these in big shad colors. So I keep them in the, I think it's called a hitch color, and then the ghost shad from Strike King. And I've got 4.75 and 5.8s. I've got that many of them. I usually throw these on a quarter to a half ounce head, unless I'm going to try to get super deep, then I'll go to a 3/4. For the most part, a quarter to a half ounce head, get it down 5 or 6 foot and just creep it along some kind of a drop or over some isolated cover or something like that. And I've caught some really, really good ones doing that, and a lot of fish doing it as well. So one entire bag to roughly 5 inch swim baits. Now, my favorite swim bait to throw, I've only been experimenting with these. I've actually been experimenting with these for a few years, but I haven't really got on the bite super, super good until this year. And that's the line through style swim baits. So I keep a few different brands. I got an Osprey right here. I'm not super impressed with those, to be honest, but I have caught a bunch of fish on them, and they do really, really work. They just don't have quite as good action as some other brands, in my opinion. Some people love them, some people hate them. That's just how it goes. This right here is the Optimum Boom Boom Shad. I keep a couple of these in the boat at all times, because whenever it goes down on this line through swim bait, I have the confidence that in an hour I can put a giant bag in the boat, because they really do eat it, and you don't lose a lot of fish on it, which is super nice for a bait that's this heavy and gets that big of bites. So I keep a bag full of these line through swim baits in my boat. Another thing that I keep in here is some weedless style swim baits. So that's another line through, just a little bit smaller one. And I keep, you know, some of these more that I can rig weedless or rig on a jig head. Like this right here is a custom poured one that's from up around Chickamauga, I believe. And this right here is a pack of those Boom Boom swim baits that are weedless. I can put these on a belly weighted hook and throw them around some grass or something like that. So I keep these in the boat, and then everything else is just a big bag of weedless ones. And then a couple more, three more actual line through swim baits. This is a little bit different one right here. Got a big old head on it. Looks kind of like a goby. Maybe a smallmouth will eat that sucker up. And then a couple more line throughs, because whenever you're really, really catchable on this line through, it's really easy to, because you want a good swim bait is a very soft swim bait. So whenever you're fishing and catching a lot of fish on this, it's very easy to rip the bait and destroy the bait in just like 5 or 6 fish. If I'm really on a good bite with it, I might catch 20 in a day. That means I might have to go through 3 or 4 of these, you know, line throughs. And if I'm catching them on this exact one, I want to have 3 of this exact one. So I try to keep a couple extras in here at all times just in case I get on the bite. For the most part, I try to throw very soft swim baits, but that comes with a price. You're going to tear them up a little bit more. So that's the line through swim baits I keep. That's every single swim bait that I keep in my boat at all times. Way too many Kytex, which I need to calm that down a little bit, because the Untamed Tackle Scout swimbait head's got that 4-way keeper on it and holds it up really well. I'm not going to tear it up too much. So I can probably get away with taking a few of those boxes out, but at the same time, I want to be prepared no matter what circumstances I'm given in practice. So that's the swimbaits I keep in my boat. Hope you enjoyed that video. I got to pack these suckers back up now after I done showed y'all all these goodies. Go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Me and Hunter are pulling out in the morning to go to New York. Going to be some cool videos up there. Hopefully going to smash them. So leave a like, leave a comment, hit that subscribe button. I really appreciate it. I will see y'all in the next video.